As long as people have been looking up, they've noticed patterns in the nighttime sky. Some people would see a bear, some people might see a hunter, and you could come up with stories of what those shapes might mean. But now we know those stories take us far, far deeper into the scientific tales of where the universe came from. The stars rise and set like the sun because the earth is turning. And the stars change with the seasons because the earth is moving around the sun. But if you wait long enough, much longer than the human lifetime, you would see that everything in the nighttime sky is going to change its position because everything is in motion. One of the basic understandings in physics is that once you're set in motion, you stay in motion. The Big Bang was a very dynamic process, and at the time of the Big Bang, everything was set into motion. Since that time, everything has been kept in motion. Every star in the nighttime sky that you see when you walk outside is moving. One particular space-based observatory that has revolutionized our understanding is called Gaia. Gaia's intention was to map the Milky Way and beyond. Over the course of my career in astrophysics, I've seen our understanding of the cosmos completely change when the Gaia Space Telescope revealed the nearly 2 billion star map. It was so critical because everything depends on these maps of objects to understand the fundamentals of how stars work, of how planets work with the stars. So now with this information, we can see for almost 2 billion stars where they are and where they're going. We can move 4 million years into the future and see constellations like Leo the lion, or Taurus the bull, or Scorpius the scorpion, changing over time, morphing in their structures into something different. The sun is also in motion. It's orbiting the center of the galaxy. It takes roughly 225 million years for the sun to make its lap around the Milky Way. And it's about 20 times since the sun was born that we've made laps around. So the solar system itself is roughly 20 galactic years old. As the sun makes its travels around the galaxy, the neighborhood changes. Your neighbors change. All of the stars are on different paths as they move around the galaxy. Wait 100 million years, and you're going to be roughly on the other side of the galaxy, completely different neighborhood. For the length of human civilization's existence, we haven't moved all that much in our path around the galaxy. But when humans were first starting to walk upright, we did enter a very strange area of the galaxy. An area that was ignited by several supernova, giant explosions. Now that led to us having a gorgeous view of the nighttime sky, as the area that we're currently in the galactic neighborhood, is relatively clear of gas and dust because these supernovas swept out the area. Now, we won't be in here forever. We will exit this thing that we call the local bubble in a couple million years. And when we do, our view of the nighttime sky will probably change. You won't have as good of a view of all of the stars. It might look a little bit murkier. We won't have as crisp, clear view out into the cosmos. In some ways, being inside of the bubble, as humans were developing technology that would allow us to study the universe, is a wonderful coincidence of motion and how life has evolved. Mapping the positions of stars and even the sun's place amongst the stars isn't necessarily new with today's technology. we're just way better at it right now. But you could actually go back and look at even ancient drawings, compare them to today's catalogs, and detect some of that same stellar motion that we're so excited to see in today's modern astrophysics catalogs. Astrophysics today has this pretty well mapped for a specific kind of star, for a brightness of a star, but you never know what you're gonna get because we are on a journey. The entire solar system is on this traveling ship, which is moving around the Milky Way. We'll move through different areas, we'll encounter different kinds of objects, we will get closer and farther from things that the nighttime sky has brought us to understand, and the journey will hopefully help us understand better our place in the universe.